Question 27. The author's use of the words exact, specific, and complement in lines 47 to 49 in the final paragraph functions mainly to A. Confirm that the nucleotide sequences are known for most molecules of DNA. B. To counter the claim that the sequences of bases along a chain can occur in any order. C. To support the claim that the phosphate sugar backbone of the author's model is completely regular. And C. To emphasize how one chain of DNA may serve as a template to be copied during DNA replication. The best answer to this question is D. To emphasize how one chain of DNA may serve as a template to be copied during DNA replication. Let's understand how. In lines 43 to 44, the authors explain how the DNA molecule contains a precise sequence of bases and that the authors can use the order of bases on one chain to determine the order of bases on the other. The evidence for this is this. If the actual order of the bases on one of the pair of chains were given, one could write down the exact order of the bases on the other one because of the specific pairing. Thus, one chain, as it were, the complement of the other, and it is this feature which suggests how the deoxyribonucleic acid molecule might duplicate itself. The authors hence can be said use the words exact, specific, and complement in these lines to suggest the base pairings along a DNA chain is understood and predictable and may explain how the DNA duplicates itself. Choice A is incorrect because the passage does not suggest that most nucleotide sequences are known. Choice B is incorrect because these lines are not discussing the random nature of the base sequence along one chain of DNA. And choice C is incorrect because the authors are describing the bases attached only to the sugar, not to the sugar phosphate backbone.